this week, I want to put you guys onto something. This video is going to be a relatively short and simple one, but I think you're going to get a lot out of it because today I wanted to share with you what is, in my humble opinion, the single most useful feature in After Effects. That effect is called Timewarp, and today I wanted to share with you why you might want to use it, how to use it, and a few different creative ways to take advantage of it for your videos. What Timewarp does is it allows you to adjust the speed of your clip regardless of the speed that you're speeding it up to or slowing it down to. And to take a look at why this is important, let's break down 1 second of footage. So let's say we have 1 second on a 24 frames per second timeline. So we have 24 frames and we're editing footage that was shot at 60 frames per second. So let's say we slow that footage down to 40% of its speed. 40% of 60 is exactly 24. So we're gonna have exactly 24 frames per second. It divides perfectly and we're gonna have perfectly smooth slow motion. If we slow it down to 80% speed, 80% of 60 is exactly 48. So we have exactly 48 frames in that 1 second. So Premiere can basically just skip every other frame and we still have smooth motion. But let's say we slow that 60 frames per second footage down to 50% speed, then we have exactly 30 frames per second. So what Premiere has to do is put 30 frames in a 24 frame window. So it has to skip 6 of those frames. So because we're skipping 6 frames, you're gonna have 6 points per second where you're gonna skip a little bit ahead in that video. And you might not really notice it at first, but the more you get used to editing and the more attention you pay to something like this, you're gonna start to notice it in your own videos and other people's edits, and it just makes the clip look choppy. The first thing you need to do is interpret your footage before you start editing. And this is something that you should probably be doing anyway. A lot of like timeline issues with syncing and speed can be avoided just by interpreting your footage before you edit. But especially for this effect, it's really important to be interpreting your footage before you start working with it. So what I'm gonna do is interpret my 60 frames per second footage to 24 frames per second because I always edit on a 24 frames per second timeline. So basically what I'm gonna do is select all of that 60 FPS footage in the project window, right click, go to modify, then hit interpret footage and set the frame rate to 24 frames per second. And boom, you've interpreted your footage from 60 to 24. This is the best way to do slow motion. It's much better than dragging your footage onto the timeline and then slowing it down to 40% speed, which is the alternative. So always interpret your footage. Since I've already interpreted that footage from 60 to 24, it's essentially at 40% speed when I put it on the timeline. So I'm gonna be then speeding it up to, let's say, 134%. Very unorthodox, specific number. If we take a close look at that clip after we speed it up, we can see some of those frames actually being skipped because we've sped it up to an unorthodox amount. So now I'm just gonna right click that clip and replace it with an After Effects composition. And you'll notice since we've set that speed to 134%, once you open After Effects, the first frame of the clip might be partially cut off, so you might not see anything. So just zoom in and drag the endpoint back to the endpoint of the composition, and that should fix the issue. Just another one of those little bits and bobs with the Adobe After Effects and Premiere Dynamic Link that doesn't work quite as well as they make it sound like it does. Honestly, you might as well use Final Cut, but that's not what this video is about. Now, before I use Timewarp, I like to duplicate the clip and use Timewarp on the top layer only, so we have that bottom layer that serves as a reference and something that we can use later if we need to. Now, once I've duplicated the clip on that top layer, I'm gonna right click it, then go to time and hit time stretch and set it back to 100%. So then we're basically negating what we did in Premiere when we set the speed to 134%. We're setting it back to 100. If we were to just go ahead and drag Timewarp onto our clip, Timewarp analyzes the clip from the endpoint of the entire clip rather than the endpoint of the selection you made. So you're gonna notice that your selection is thrown off. You might be in a completely different part of the video than you selected. To fix that, before you drag Timewarp onto the clip, just pre-compose it and you're good to go. And now if we just drag Timewarp onto the clip and set the speed option to the speed we want, in this case 134%, then we can hit play and we'll see that we have perfectly smooth slow motion at that exact speed. And basically the way this works is Timewarp goes in, it analyzes the frames in your video, and it basically blends them together to create fake frames to fill in the gaps where frames could be skipped. If you switch the method from pixel motion to frame blending, you can see what it's really doing here. It's taking those two frames that are competing for a slot in your video and it's blending them together. Pixel motion is basically just a way of doing that that looks a lot smoother, because instead of just laying the clips on top of each other and fading them together, it's analyzing the individual pixels and moving those pixels to create an entirely new frame. Pixel motion is pretty smart, and in a lot of cases you can honestly just go back to Premiere at this point because the effect looks pretty much perfect. But if you have a lot of motion in your clip, pixel motion can start to mess up and you'll get weird artifacts like this. And unfortunately, there's not too much you can do about this, so that's why I saved that reference layer on the bottom. So what I'm gonna do is go to the frames where pixel motion is a little screwed up and cut out those frames. It's not ideal, but you probably won't notice it in the final clip. It's a lot better than just not using pixel motion at all. Whenever you're speeding a clip up like this, it's good to add some fake motion blur after the fact so it looks as though you actually shot it at that speed. And this is where I would usually use CC Force Motion Blur in After Effects or RSMB, which is a great plugin that adds fake motion blur to your clips. But you don't need to, because Timewarp has its own motion blur feature. You can just check off the box that says enable motion blur, and it adds fake motion blur into your shot. Now it's good to set this to 180 to mimic that 180 degree shutter rule where your shutter speed is double your frame rate. So if you're shooting at 24 frames a second, 1/50th of a second for your shutter speed, setting it to 180 will basically mimic that and give you the most realistic motion blur possible. I've also found that if pixel motion messes up the clip and you get that weird artifacting, enabling motion blur is often a way to make it less noticeable, and that might actually fix the problem instead of having to cut those frames out. And if you enable motion blur and then you notice that it's not quite smooth enough, you have like some weird lines around the edges, just increase the shutter samples option and it should smooth that out. So this is probably the most common use for time warp to speed a clip up to an unorthodox speed. Some reasons you might want to do that: if you want to have it line up with the beat, for example, a lot of the times I like to have footsteps fall exactly on the beat of the music, which requires oftentimes speeding the clip up to an unorthodox speed like this. But that's not the only reason to use time warp. You can also actually use it to create fake slow motion. So if you set the speed instead of something like 134, you set it to 50, then it'll use the same frame blending option and give you fake frames to fill in the gaps where you usually would run out when creating slow motion. When you do that, you're relying a lot more on software to create a very noticeable effect for you, but it's an option. And finally, time warp is actually a great way to speed ramp as well. So if you set a keyframe for the speed at 100% and then you move forward and set it to say 300%, 400%, then you'll have a very smooth speed ramp and you won't be skipping any frames throughout that. It's actually more realistic and even a little easier than the terrible Premiere speed ramping function. I don't mean to be trashing Premiere so much in this video. I think this technique just brings out a lot of its shortcomings. But there you have it, my absolute favorite effect in Adobe After Effects. And you know what? Let's start something with this video. Now that I've shared my favorite effect in After Effects with you, how about you head down to the comments and share yours? What's something, doesn't have to be in After Effects, could be Premiere or any other program, that's absolutely changed, completely transform the way that you edit videos. But I hope you enjoyed this video or learned something new from it. If you did, do feel free to show your support by leaving a like on the video, sharing it with your friends, or even subscribing to my channel. I upload new videos just like this every week or so, and I also post on Instagram somewhat consistently, so if you want to follow me on there, I feel like I don't promote that quite enough, but I'm at Aidin Robbins, so head over there and follow me if you like pretty pictures. But that's all for now. Keep creating, and I'll see you in the next one.